Hi, this is Gary with MACMOST.com. Let me show you four different ways that you could blur the background of a photo on your Mac. MACMOST is brought to you thanks to a great group of more than 1,000 supporters. Go to MACMOST.com/Patreon. There you could read more about the Patreon campaign. Join us and get exclusive content and course discounts. So a common request online, no matter what type of computer or device you're using, is how do you take a photo and blur the background, keeping the subject in focus and the background scene blurred? Well, you can do this, of course, using many different third-party apps. So I'm going to show you how to do it with two popular ones on the Mac, and then two ways to do it without any extra apps at all. So here's the photo I'm going to use as an example. First, let's try to do this using the popular Pixelmator Pro app. Now, the way to do this in most third-party apps is to first select either the subject or the background so you can blur one and not the other. Now, there are many selection tools in Pixelmator Pro. I'm going to use the Quick Selection tool right here, but you can just as easily use a free selection or magnetic selection or any way that you can best select the foreground or background. So I'm going to select the foreground here, and you can see as I move over the subject, I can easily select it. Now, I want to refine the selection, so I'm going to zoom in and look for places where I can do a little bit better. So for instance here, maybe if I want to take something away, I can hold the Option key down and remove some from there. So in this case, the Shift key will add to the selection and the Option key will remove. So it's a little hard to get it just perfect. It helps if you zoom in a lot more so you can more easily see what's there and select in finer detail. And then you've got to go through the entire border here and find areas to add or remove. Once you've got it good enough, you can refine the selection even more. So if I go to Edit, Refine Selection, I can see the Refine tools here so I can expand or shrink maybe just a little bit in, like maybe 3% in, add a little softness to the selection. And now I've got the subject selected, but it's actually the background I want to blur. So I'm actually going to go to Edit and then Invert Selection. So now I've selected everything but the subject. Now I could go to Effects here, Add an Effect, I'm going to do a Gaussian blur. I could blur the background, change the blur amount to whatever it is I want, and then I'll deselect here so I can see the finished version. Now let's try the same thing, but I'm going to do it using Affinity Photo, another popular app for editing photos. So here there are selection tools as well. I could do the Flood Select tool and try to select that way. I could do the Selection Brush and try to select that way. It seems to work a little bit better in this case. And just like with Pixelmator, I'm going to zoom in on areas. It doesn't show you a plus or minus in there, but you can click to add more and then hold the Option key and click to remove sections. And you can keep doing that, also changing the width of the selection tool and try to get it just right. And then here you could also refine, and then maybe do a little bit of feathering there to create more of a fuzzier edge. Now I'm going to do something a little different here, another technique that would work in Pixelmator as well. I'm going to actually copy this selection here and then paste it over. So when I look at layers here, you can see I've got this new one here that's just the subject, and then there's the background. So let's get rid of the selection there. And I'm going to choose the background here, and this I'm going to apply the effect of Gaussian blur to and blur just the background. Actually, if I go to layers here, you could see if I hide that first layer, everything's blurred including the subject, but now I've got the subject layered on top of itself right here. So I've blurred everything and then put the subject back. You can do this in Pixelmator Pro and in most other apps like Photoshop as well. So that's a second way to do it using an app that you can get in the Mac App Store. But what if you just wanted to do this with the tools that come with your Mac? Well, there's no great way to do it, unfortunately, but you can try. So let's open this up in Preview, right? And you'd think there'd be a way to do this in Preview, but in fact, not really. Let's go to the markup tools. And what I'm going to do here is I'm going to go to the selection tools and I can use the smart lasso to try to select the subject. And this will create this red dot around here and try to cut out the subject based on your outline. It actually sometimes works a little bit better with the regular tools, like the lasso tool. But in this case, this is as close as we're going to get. Unfortunately, you can't refine the selection in preview. You have to do it all at once. You can't really zoom in either. So I do it here and it worked okay, but not great. So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to copy. And then I'm going to go to the adjustment tools here and blur everything. Except there is no blur. So you're going to have to simulate a blur. And it doesn't work very well. One way to do it is to take the contrast down somewhat. Maybe bring the sharpness down as well. Maybe the saturation a little bit. Take a little bit of the color out. And that kind of creates a blur. It's doing it for the whole thing here. So the subject is also less contrast. But remember, we copied the subject. So now I can paste back on top. It's center, so you're going to have to position manually right on top. Try to get as close as you can. And it kind of works. Especially if you shrink the image down in size and you're looking at a smaller image, then it works a little bit better. You don't see the imperfections. Now let me show you another way using Keynote that works pretty well, but it's pretty convoluted. Let's first start off by getting the exact pixel size here. So in preview, I can go to the information panel here, and under general, it's 3088 by 2320. So in Keynote, I'm going to create a new presentation. I'm going to get rid of everything on the first slide, go to document, and I'm going to set the slide size to a custom size and set it to exactly the size of the image. And then I'm going to shrink down so we can see it here. Then I'm going to drag and drop the image into there. Now it should snap right into place. If I go to Format, Arrange, you should see it at 0, 0. Now what I want to do first is make it blurry. So I'll select it and there's no way to blur it. You can go to Image and do the same thing that you did in Preview here to kind of fake a blur. But you could also, under Style, set the opacity down to something like 20%. Then copy, click away, and paste. And it'll paste another 20% transparent overlay. I'm going to move it over by a few pixels, like maybe 10 pixels. So Shift and right arrow to move it by 10 pixels. If I go to Arrange here, you can see it's 10 pixels to the right. I'm going to paste again, move that one 10 pixels to the left, paste again, 10 pixels up, paste again, 10 pixels down. So now I've got 5 versions of the same thing, all at slightly different positions. So when I zoom in, you can see how it's kind of blurry. So far, so good. Now we need to put on top of this a cutout version of the subject. How to do that? There's really no good way to do it with just the image. But we have the ability to create these custom shapes. Let's zoom in here and start creating a custom shape by putting lots of points here all around the subject. You can get as detailed as you want. Maybe take a little bit more time than what I'm doing. Notice how here I made a mistake. That's okay. Just keep going like that. We can fix the mistakes. I'm not even going to worry about being perfect here at the bottom. Just going to get it to go all the way around. And then to finish it off, you've got to click on the first point there. And now you've finished it. And you can see there's a line there. I can go to Style and I could set a fill, like a color fill if I want. It's a little bit easier if it's set to no fill. But the border, maybe some color to make it really easy for me to see, like a red, like that. And I can adjust any point I want now. So I can fix imperfections. Not only that, I can select a point and then hit the delete key to get rid of it. So I can fix that mistake. This mistake I can fix there and I can get this all the way down even below the bottom. Like that. And then you can work on anything else you want. You could even click to add more points like that. And you could curve out any point you want. So you can get really detailed. So then when you're done, you now have this shape here. Now you may think, oh, let's set the fill to an image fill. But that actually doesn't really work well. What does work well is with the shape selected like that, I can now drag and drop an image into it. And then the images are going to fit perfectly. I have to reposition the image inside to get it just right. And done. Now I want to get rid of that line, that red line. I don't need it anymore. And there I go. So now I've created this shape that's perfectly sized like the subject, and I've placed a copy of the image there, and then I have all these other images behind it that are kind of blurry. The results are less than perfect, but mostly because I rushed. If I took a lot of time to actually work on the outline and to align everything perfectly, it would look really good. And now, of course, this is a keynote presentation, which isn't what you want. You want to export it as an image right here. And you can choose, you know, JPEG or PNG for even higher quality. Probably just want to stick with JPEG. And then we'll export this to the desktop. I'm not going to bother to name it, but you get a folder here, and inside the folder you get this image. I can take it out of the folder and get rid of the folder. And you can see here's the original image in Quick Look, and then here's the version I made in Keynote. So really, if you want to do this kind of thing right, you want to get an app like Affinity Photo or Pixelmator Pro to do it. Of course, you can also use Photoshop or any other image editing app. They're all going to have these basic tools in them. But if you really want to figure out a way to do it using the tools that come with your Mac, you can kind of simulate this with Preview or Keynote by putting a little bit more effort into it if you don't mind the imperfect results. Hope you found this useful. Thanks for watching. If you liked this video, click the thumbs up button below to let me know. I publish new tutorials each weekday. Hit the subscribe button so you don't miss out.